Monica Garrett, studying in Valhati Public School, Pithampura, New Delhi, in 10th standard. My topic for today is the inspirational achievements of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. The 11th President of India, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, born in 1931 to a little educated boat owner in Rameshwaram, Tamil Nadu, he had an unparalleled career as a defense scientist, culminating in the highest civilian award of India, the Bharat Ratna, even before he became the president. As he created successful weaponry for our country, he was able to maintain the ascetic rigor of his personal life, working 18 hours a day and playing the veena. Always modest by characteristics, he ascribed the greatness of his achievements to his teachers and mentors. His life story is not just one about personal triumphs and tribulations. It is a saga of independent India's struggle to establish in itself technological self-sufficiency and defense autonomy. A story as much political, domestic and international, as much as it is about the establishment of modern science in India, struggling to establish itself in the technological forefront. It is a story of national aspirations and cooperative endeavors. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam came to office as the President of India in 2002 with full majority. The most difficult decision that he took in his tenure was signing of the Office of Profit Bill, a decision that gave him the name of People's President. Known as the Missile Man of India, he was the director of India's first satellite launch vehicle. He had a vision of creating low-cost medical devices using indigenous methods, and he went on to create the Kalam Rajan Coronary Stent. He also played a very pivotal role in the Pokhran 2 nuclear test of India that took place in 1998, and he was known as the best nuclear scientist in our nation. His story is one of sheer determination and hard work. It is a story of a young boy from a small town of Rameshwaram working by selling newspapers at a young age to help supplement his family's income, gaining as much knowledge as he could on the way, going on to become the President of India. He used to say always that the satellites and missiles that he creates are God's work by a small man named Kalam to show the several million masses of India never to feel small or helpless. He had great affection for the ordinary people of India, for whom he worked and of whom he certainly is one. Even at retirement in 1991, at the age of 60, he took the decision to spend the rest of his life completing his duties in the social sphere. He has always worked for the benefit of the nation, writing inspiring books, encouraging the Indian youth, and creating successful missiles for our country. He is one of the major reasons for the technological and defensive advancements in our country today. He may not be in the world with us anymore, but in the hearts of the people of India, the People's President stays alive forever. Ever encouraging of the Indian youth, he has been known to quote once, "We are all born with a divine fire in us, and it should be our effort to give wings to this fire and to spread the light of its goodness all throughout the world." This was the inspiration, the legacy that drove him from the small town of Rameshwaram to become the Missile Man of India, and finally to the hearts of each and every Indian as our beloved People's President. Thank you.